So my question is, are there any like liaisons that are a part of you guys for the different regions to make sure there's like consistent and effective communication with the counties?
We don't necessarily have liaisons per se. What we do have is a district structure with our members. So we have seven different districts, which are effectively our regions within the state, and each district has a director of sorts. It's one of our members that serve, and I can't profess that I could rattle them off the top of my head right now, the seven different ones. But I would say, aside from those various regional districts that we have, which, you know, based on geography and different things, you know, certainly the association itself, is able to serve as that liaison, whether myself, Melissa, or any of our staff, whether it's from the southeast to, the northern tier of Pennsylvania, we pride ourselves on building strong relationships with our members. So if there are if there's interest of, connecting locally with members of our association from, say, yourself or any member of the General Assembly, for that matter, or staff, we're happy to coordinate and make those conversations happen and utilize, whatever resources our members have to be able to work together, because that's ultimately their aim, and our aim is to again, back to my point earlier, is to be able to build and bridge relationships here with the General Assembly and our member counties, because again, mutual constituents, their constituents or your constituents. So we could certainly work with you on that and determine how we can best leverage our membership and build those connections with you locally in our regions.
Okay, thank you. I was just asking that because to piggyback off of Representative Wade, I know he talked a little bit more about transitioning, but I asked that question because I'm sure everyone can see nationally, but even here in PA, we do have a big housing crisis. And one of the issues is that the counties are right now having to answer for those housing crises. And I just asked that because I wanted to know there was like partnership communicating with the counties and also with like the, the bus transportation centers and so forth, because that's kind of where predominantly is happening. And I'm finding the counties having to communicate with them, which is great. But just wanted to know, because it's not just mental health, but well, it's part of mental health too, but a lot of them even with substance abuse, and so forth. So I'm just trying to figure out like how, the communication is going on, mm-hmm. because we have a lot of counties in the state.
Yeah.
So even with seven district members, that's great, but I'm sure if they're in charge of one region and we have different counties that are, suffering or facing more challenges than maybe than others, then that's my concern. But I think right now, I can't say, but I'm sure almost everybody here probably have some big significant challenges when it comes to homelessness or crisis that they're seeing all around, and substance abuse that the counties right now are having to handle on their own.
Yeah, and we have one of our affiliate organizations is also the Human Service Administrators, and so they're generally who handle the housing. So whether that's, a Human Service Administrator who's handling the drug and alcohol, the mental health and intellectual disability, or kind of, focusing more on the housing and community relations side of things. Mm-hmm. We have that association as well, so we'd be happy to connect you since they do kind of more of that on the ground work.
Thank you. I would appreciate that.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's it.